Hello again from Gubaševo, Croatia. It's autumn, second week of weekend of October, and we have a nice clear sky, high pressure weather system over most of the South Europe, and it's quite windy here. Runway is almost exactly aligned with north-south, and we have a wind from southwest, so it's blowing at an angle to a runway, which makes all the pilots fly downwind towards the hill over there and the village. Yesterday we've seen an amazing number of zero score flights landing far, far out, some of them even in the village and up on the trees in the hill. And these are the top 10 pilots now. I hope they will be smarter than that and be able to come back. Some of them are going downwind immediately. Most of them, I guess, sooner or later. And no one is really low. So yesterday it was interesting to see people starting at 30, 50, 80 meters, which was typically enough for a clear sky like this. But the turbulence caused by the hill behind us was really, really unpredictable, and planes were jumping up and down 10 meters or more. So starting low wasn't really the best idea here. And it took people almost a day to realize that. This morning the situation was much the same, but all the starts I've seen were 150 meters or above, and suddenly the scores started to improve a lot. Who is this here? Could be Primož Rižner. Let's see if he can make it out of low height. Oh, manual focus. Got a pretty good climb out of that, but now he needs to find another thermal. Based on the comments I hear below me, there is a plane in there, and I hear it's Arjan Huceljuk, the world championship, the world champion. there, I think. So at least he can see the plane better than I can, at least. For me, this big tree is in the way. Can't really tell what he's doing. But in the meantime, interesting things happening. So Primoš is still fighting. He was still not able to climb out. And this was much the same yesterday as it is now. So from, let's say, 50 to maybe 150 or 200 meters, it was very turbulent and going up and down all the time, maybe a thermal good for 3 turns or so, and then you had to look for another one. Today in the morning there was a bit less wind, and also the conditions in the air felt much more laminar. It was kind of easier to fly and the thermals were longer living. Possible to find a thermal and get maybe 200-300 meters out of it. But looks like now again winged picked up a bit, and we have the same turbulent conditions down over the runway in the valley. Almost feels like there's a inversion layer, maybe at the height of the hilltop or something similar, because even for best pilots it's difficult to climb above that layer. But as far as I can see, some managed fine. Looks like Primoš is now coming back again, trying for another thermal. Let's see if he manages. For a landing, apparently. At least he'll be within 75. But okay, so that's not Primoš. So scratch that's what I was talking for the last 8 minutes. I think that was one of the Bulgarian guys. Flying. Now the closest plane that I can see, all others are either higher or farther out. But it's time to come back now, with about 4 minutes of flying remaining. quite high. Okay, you've heard that, 5 minutes to go. And they're all high enough, so they all they need is just to return home safely. And let's wait for their landings. It's now about 1 minute and 45 seconds. Looks like some pilots are already landing a bit early. Trying for every last second they can get. One minute to go. Looks like that could be just enough. Seconds. Now I expect more planes in this part of the sky. He just made it. Nice, nice, very good, very good. Flight one done, two more to go. Arjan just arrived with car from his plane rescue mission, and there's less than 1 minute to start the second flight. Now it's seconds. So he was not able to put the plane together. Now I see similar strategy, going into the wind a bit, finding something and then getting yourself carried off by the wind. Pilots. He also got the same Explorer design with the inverted horizontal tail, slightly pointed down, as Arjan has. landing anything from that height will be challenging. Another V-tail explorer. So this is again either Primož or Stojčo. So okay, Primož is looking downwind. Who is this then? Almost made it to the corridor, but not to the point. Next brave low pilot. Let's see who this is. That's an Ultima 2 being flown by either Herman Haas, the Austrian pilot, or Gregor Urbančič. But Gregor is looking completely different direction, so it must be Herman. Now about 10 second long wind gust. Let's see if it will help them in any way. There are not two planes low. Herman is a bit closer to the corridor and there is one a bit further downwind. But looks like he is going for landing. One more circle. Guy will land outside, unfortunately. And then the rest are far out, downwind, over the village, approaching the hill, I guess. still in need of enough height to actually come back. There's one who decided to come back early, which is a wise choice in this kind of conditions. There's no one really low anymore or in a interesting situation, so it's just the landings left, I guess. And there are people walking fetching planes from very far away. Okay, let's wait for landings then. It's about 5 minutes to go. It's now about 1.5 minute to go. Okay, 1 minute. Pilots finished out of 10. Quite amazing. So let's wait for the third and hopefully last flyoff. Some minutes before the start, and some pilots are relaxed after 2 good flights. Some are looking for what to do for the last start. So just less than a minute before the start, there is a pair of birds circling over the village, indicating where to go, but with the wind speed and direction, I think that thermal will be already way too far for them to catch, unfortunately. No idea whom to follow now. Those that had two good starts now picked a safe choice and started high. And there are a few guys still trying to do something at the low height. And you see just how difficult it is to see your plane with such a colorful background, with buildings and trees and meadows and whatnot. So there's a plane there, almost looks like it's in some masking colors. And this is no way you can get out of right now. Maybe one more circle and land. No, he's still fighting, but there's not enough energy to do one more circle. Other two guys are a bit higher. Looks like they're climbing. And all the others are now really high. Not risking anything. And it looks like they will all make this flight without much problems. So this is my 13th competition this year. Also last one for me. Although there are a few more on the FAI calendar. This year I won't be able to go to Greece, unfortunately. Although I would very much like to attend that competition too. Still being at 13th competition in a year, I think that's quite a feat. Once the World Cup results are out, I will check how many other people did similar number of competition or more. And I guess only the plane manufacturers and dealers will be at similar number of competitions, and not many more other people. It's a kind of service I try to provide, although this year was exceptional with the first World Championship, and I'm pretty sure I won't go to this many competitions next year. You know, there's also a thing called life that needs to be taken care of, and F5J is just a hobby. I was thinking, how can I expand and develop the channel I have here on YouTube? And there are a couple of options I could see, but none is really interesting for a wider audience. So developing channel into a YouTube business is out of question. The target audience is simply too small. So I'm actually interested in what you guys, my viewers, think, what you would like to see. Let me know in the comments below. I think right now I'm pretty unique, covering competitions in Europe area. I've seen some competitions being on YouTube from US, and I would also like to see some from, let's say, South America or Australia or anywhere else really, just to show that this is really international, worldwide sport. It's not centered only on Europe. Minutes to go, and two planes down from the amazing height they were at. maybe if I continue with my retrospective, I started flying F5J in 2004, and back then we were still very much focused on limiting the available motor power with the weight and chemistry of the batteries. And it took us almost a decade to switch that thinking to use the altimeters. So I was involved with the creation of rules and synchronization of the rules across a few countries in the neighborhood. So I'm from Slovenia, and we had a thing called Eurocup with neighboring Hungary and Slovakia as well. And all those efforts I put in back then kinda pushed me to the FAI working group that established the final F5J rule. And I'm still kinda in those circles deciding of where we decide the future of this wonderful sport. So we got it from a hobby to sport now under the cover of FAI. So we can do things like world championships and continental championships, which are mostly European. But let's see how soon some other continent decides to hold their own local championship. Asia could be an interesting place for that. Maybe South America or South Africa as well. Go. You saw some victory loops from Primož Rižner. Now I'm sure this time that this is his plane, because the other V-tail Explorer landed already. Strong wind.
Neka samo Damjanović Marko.
Arjan.
Damjanović Marko.
Dominic.
Thank you, everybody.
I call you to visit us in April. We have next competition here in April by Dlaka, by the Damir, and my competition will be in October, like every year. So have a nice trip. Drive carefully, and thank you what you come.